Sir, your number, sir. Thank you. Lot 663, then, ladies and gentlemen. A poster for this house is production of Annabelle by Shalumbo.
Showing here.
Do I have 10 francs for this? 5, then. 5 and bid. Thank you. 6. 6. Do I see 7? 7 against you, sir, at 7. 8. 8 once. Selling twice. Sold for 8 francs to Raoul, Vicomte de Chagny. Thank you very much, sir. Lot 664. A wooden pistol and 3 human skulls from the 1831 production of Robert Le Diable by Meyerbeer. 10 francs for this. 10, thank you, sir. 10, I am bid. 10 francs, sir. 15. 15, and it going at 15. Your number, sir. Thank you. Lot 665. A papier-mâché musical box in the shape of a barrel organ. Attached, the figure of a monkey in Persian robes playing the cymbals. This item, discovered in the vaults of the theatre. Still in working order, ladies and gentlemen.
Showing here.
May I commence at 20 francs? Oh, come, come, ladies and gentlemen, 15 then. 15 and bid, thank you, yes. 20 from you, sir.
25.
25 on my left. Thank you, madam. 30. Selling for 30 francs then, 30 once. 30 twice. Sold for 30 francs to the Vicomte de Chagny. Thank you once again, sir.
Boy.
Lot 666. A chandelier in pieces. Some of you may recall the strange affair of the Phantom of the Opera. A mystery never fully explained. We are told, ladies and gentlemen, that this is the very chandelier which figures in the famous disaster. Our jobs have restored it and fitted parts of it with wiring for the new electric light. So we will get a hint of how it may look when reassembled. Perhaps we may frighten away the ghost of so many years ago with a little illumination. Gentlemen!
Thank you.
We say gentlemen,
this way. Rehearsals, as you see, are underway for a new production of Chalamet's Hannibal. Ladies and gentlemen, some of you may already perhaps have met Monsieur André and Monsieur Firmin.
We're rehearsing. If you wouldn't mind waiting a moment.
My apologies, Monsieur Bray. Proceed. Proceed.
Thank you, Monsieur Factory Turn, Signor.
Signor.
Monsieur Ray, our chief repetiteur. Rather a tyrant, I'm afraid.
Yes. Saturi tango final and villa.
Signor.
Piacere, signor.
I remember rightly. Elissa has a wife.
fine aria in Act 3 of Hamlet. I wonder, Signora, if as a personal favor you would oblige us with a private rendition. Unless, of course, Monsieur Grey objects.
My manager commands.
Monsieur
Rayet! And my diva commands.
Would 2 bars be sufficient introduction?
2 bars will be quite sufficient.
Signora!
Maestro?
There's much more I can do to assist you, gentlemen. Good luck. If you need me, I shall be in Frankfurt.
Now, Carlotta, we'll be back.
You think so, monsieur? I have a message, sir, from the opera ghost.
Oh, bloody heaven, you're all obsessed.
He merely welcomes you to his opera house, commands that you continue to leave box 5 empty for his use, and reminds you that his salary is due.
His salary.
Monsieur Lefebvre paid him 20,000 francs a month. Perhaps you can afford more with the Vicomte de Chauny as your patron.
Madame, I have hoped to have made that announcement myself.
Will the Vicomte be at the performance this evening, monsieur?
In our bar,
Madame, who is the understudy for the role?
There is no understudy, monsieur. The production is new.
Christine Dyer can sing it, sir.
The chorus girl.
She's been taking lessons from a great teacher.
From?
Not you as well! Can you believe it, Andre? A full house, so we have to cancel!
Let her sing for you, monsieur. She has been well taught.
Very well. Oh, from the beginning of the hour, oh, gentlemen, please. Mademoiselle.
Nerd.
Reflective film.
And that day, and not so distant.
chance to give you this.
Gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind, this is one visit I should prefer to make unaccompanied.
As you wish, monsieur.
They appear to have met before.
Christine Daae, where is your red scarf?
Monsieur.
You can't have lost it. After all the trouble I took, I was just 14 and soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf? Oh, wow, so it is you.
Christine!
Of fashion, basking in your must pay homage to you.
you little lying denier, you little viper, now you cannot ever be free. Oh, damn you, oh, just you. Stranger than you dreamt it, can you even dare to look or bear to those two fools who run my theatre will be missing you.
Where is she? I want an answer.
I take it that you sent me this note.
What on is that it?
Of course not.
Then look at us.
She's not with you then.
Of course not. We're in the dark.
If you don't argue, isn't this the letter you wrote?
And what is it that we're meant to have wrote? Written.
Do not fear for Miss Dye. The angel of music has her under his wing. Make no attempt to see her again.
Well, if you didn't, who did?
Where is he?
Now look at Ben.
Your precious wife, but where is he?
What is it now?
I have a letter which I rather resent.
Then did you send it?
Of course not.
As if he would.
But you didn't send it?
Of course not.
What's going on?
You've got to tell me. This is not the letter you sent.
And what is it that I meant to have sent? Your days in the opera populaire are numbered. Christine Daae will be singing on your behalf tonight. Prepared for a great misfortune, should you attempt to take her place.
Far too many lips for my taste.
Enough of them about Christine.
All we've heard since you came is Miss Dye's name.
Miss Dye has returned.
In which case, I think our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I thought it best. She went home.
She needed rest.
May I see her?
Oh, monsieur, she will sing no one.
Will she sing? Will she sing?
Here, I have a note.
Say she, please!
Gentlemen, I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theatre is to run. You have not followed my instructions.
I shall give you one last chance. Christine Tye has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress in the new production of Il Muto. You will therefore cast Carlotta as the page boy and put Miss Dye in the role of Countess. The role which Miss Dye plays calls for charm and appeal. The role of the page boy is silent, which makes my casting, in a word, ideal. I shall watch the performance from my normal seat in box 5, which will be kept empty for me. Should these commands be ignored,
a disaster beyond your imagination will occur. I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christine!
Whatever the name is,
I
don't have to
hear
you! This is insane!
I know simply stuff they can't tell her!
Indeed, can you believe this is me?
No!
Christine, fly from the heart of his, and I'm finding us.
Oh,
it's
in
the
angel.
Serafimo, oh baby, this pretense.
dying.
Well,
don't worry, I'm with you.
In the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, we shall be giving you the ballet. From Act 3 of tonight's opera. I still bring the ballet to me. The ballet.
Ladies and gentlemen, proud, all the creme de la creme.
Watching us
and all of the years in the
seas of relief
and
of Elysium.
As we can dream out of
Lord of
health.
Here's a text to a prosperous year. To the new chandelier. What a blessed release. And what a masquerade.
A secret engagement look. If you could share a ride, just sleep on it.
But is it secret? What have we to hide? Promise, promise me.
Without these so
let them see it's an engagement, not a crime. Your chains are still mine. You will sing for me.
Madame Stewart! Madame! Madame Stewart!
Monsieur, don't ask me. I know no more than anyone else.
That's not true. You've seen something, haven't you?
I don't know what I've seen. Please, monsieur, don't ask me.
Madame, for all our sakes.
rogues are travelling fair in the city. Tumblers, conjurers, human oddities.
Go on.
And there was... I shall never forget. A man locked in a cage.
In a cage?
A prodigy, monsieur. Scholar, architect, musician.
A composer.
And an inventor, to monsieur. He boasted he had once built for the Shah of Persia. Maze of mirrors.
Who was this man?
A freak of nature, more monster than man.
Devolved.
From birth it seemed.
My God.
And then he went to the sea. They escaped.
Go on.
They never found him. It was said he had died.
But he didn't die, did he?
The world forgot him. But I never can. For in this darkness,
so
I have seen him again. I have said too much, monsieur. Too much.
Wait.
There have been too many accidents.
Accidents? Madame Jury!
Ludicrous! Have you seen the score?
Simply ludicrous!
It's the final straw.
This is lunacy, but you know why the
utter lunacy.
But we dare refuse.
Not another chandelier.
Look, my friend, what we have here.
Dear Andre, my orchestrations. We need another first bassoon. Every note's overblown, and a third trombone has to go. The man could not be deafer, so he's preferably one who plays in tune.
Here, here, and vis-a-vis my opera, some chorus members must be sacked. If you could find out which has a sense of pitch, wisely though, I've managed to assign a rather minor role to those who cannot act. Not you as well. Please understand.
Signor, signora.
The things I have to do for my aunt.
Signor, for this art.
Here's our little flower.
I miss dying by the lady of the hour.
You have secured the largest role in this Don Juan. Come
and sing by her. She doesn't have the voice.
Signore, please. Then I take it your agrees.
It appears we have no choice.
She's the one behind this.
How dare you!
You evil woman, how dare you!
You think I'm
lying?
This isn't my fault. I don't want any part of this
plot.
Miss
Dying,
surely.
But why not?
What does she say? It's your decision, but why not?
She's working out.
You have a duty.
Come on, sing it. Duty or not?
Christine, you don't have to. They can't make you.
Please, monsieur, another note.
Fondest greetings to you all. A few instructions just before rehearsal starts. Carlotta must be taught to act.
Not the normal trick of strutting round the stage. Our Don Juan must lose some weight. It's not healthy in a man of Ganges' age. And my managers must learn that their place is in an office, not the arts. As for Miss Christine Dye, no doubt she'll do her best, it's true. Is good, she knows though, should she wish to excel, she has much still to learn, if pride will let her return to me,
but remember, we hold the peace. If this guy sings, he is silent.
certain to attend.
We make certain the doors are locked.
We make certain our men are dead.
We make certain they're armed.
The curtain falls. His reign will end.
I'm not so sure.
Not if it works.
The tide will turn. Monsieur,
believe me, there is a way of turning the tide.
You stick to Mellie.
Then help us.
Monsieur, I can't.
Instead of warning us, help us.
I wish I could.
Don't make excuses.
Could it be that you're on his side?
She is a dumbass.
Can every please see your PNG after 7?
Thank you. to secure the doors. It is essential that all doors are properly secured.
Andre! Are you sure I'm doing the right thing?
You have a better idea.
Monsieur le Vicar, am I to give the order?
Give the order. You, in the pit, do you have a clear view of this box?
Yes, sir.
Remember, when the time comes, shoot. Only if you have to, but shoot to kill.
How will I know, sir?
You'll know.
Monsieur le Vicar, are you confident that this will work? Will Miss Dye say?
Don't worry, fair man.
Andre, we're in your hands, monsieur.
My men are now in position, sir.
Go ahead, then.
Oh, the doors! Secure!
But Monsieur le Vicomte!
No buts! For once, Monsieur le Vicomte is right. Seal my fate tonight. I hate to have to cut the fun short, but the joke's wearing thin. Let the audience in. Let my opera
I have brought you
also denied me the joys of the flesh. This face, the infection which poisons our love.
Thank you.
me. Forget all of this. Leave me alone. Forget all you see. Go now. Don't let them find you. Take the boat, swear to me, never to tell. The secret you know of the angel is...